time is it? You know what time it is. It's time to hit that subscribe button, and you know where it's at. Right down there. Right down there. And it's time to follow my Instagram, Geekly Amanda, G-E-E-K-O-Y Amanda. It's the same on Twitter. And it's time to get this series review started. You guys, I had the chance to watch Disney Plus's new series, at least the first three episodes of WandaVision, which comes on Disney Plus tomorrow, January 15th, and I loved it. Let me tell you, it was weird. It was strange and clever and zany and just fun and funny, and I am here for it. It is something so different that Marvel's ever done before, and I am looking forward to seeing the more episodes, because let me tell you, after the third, it left me on a cliffhanger, and I need to know. As you know, it brings back the characters we know and love. Scarlet Witch, Elizabeth Olsen, who plays Wanda, and Paul Bettany, Vision, who we know from the Avengers. And it's set in like this suburbia America back in the day. It's supposed to be set after the Avengers Endgame. But the thing is, you would think with the Endgame movies that, you know, it's kind of in the future, even present day. No, WandaVision starts out, we're in like 1950s. And it's like we're in a sitcom. Now imagine it. Imagine the first episode set in the 1950s and it's the Dick Van Dyke Show. But instead of Rob and Laura that we know from the Dick Van Dyke Show, you have Vision and Wanda, the Scarlet Witch. We have the black and white. We have the zany comedy, but you also hear like laugh tracks with every little joke. You have a nosy neighbor played by Katherine Hahn, who is hilarious. It doesn't stop there. Each episode seems to be in its own decade. The 1950s, we get the first episode, and that's kind of like the feel of the Dick Van Dyke Show. But then you go into the second episode, and it's the 60s, and it's more like the Bewitched episode, you know? And instead of the little wiggle of the nose, you have Scarlet Witch doing her little magic, but do a little hand maneuver. And in the third episode, it all of a sudden becomes like Technicolor. And we're in the Brady Bunch, like the 1970s. As WandaVision gives homage to each of these vintage television series, you're also kind of led on a different story and a different path, because weird things start happening outside of this television episode. Although each episode has, you know, the same characters. You see the nosy neighbor, Katherine Hahn, over there who plays Agnes, and you see, you know, other characters from each episode. But each episode also has a different setting. Wanda and Vision have a different house in each. Like I said, one of them is black and white, one of it's color. It's such, I'm telling you, it's so different. It's so clever. And you were watching this and you wouldn't even think you're in a Marvel, watching a Marvel series. You wouldn't. Clearly these two, I mean, you have Vision, who does a good job of covering up his looks, the red face and everything in each, but you know, they're living in these suburbia times, but also having to cover up their magic and act like normal suburbia kind of, you know, couple. It kind of reminded me like of the Coneheads. Remember that? Where you clearly see these Coneheads characters that have the cones and they look like they're alien in outer space, but nobody really pays attention to it. It gave me that feeling. And I'm going to tell you, although I'm a Marvel fan and so glad that they're back ever, I mean, this is really the first thing since Avengers Endgame, I was really caught up in the nostalgia of it all. I mean, even watching the Bewitched episode, which was one of my favorites, let me tell you. One of my favorites, had me cracking up. But I wanted more of just that episode. I wanted to see Wanda and Vision give me more episodes of their Bewitched characters. The performances, let me tell you, incredible. I already mentioned Katherine Hahn, who plays the nosy neighbor, Agnes. She had me cracking up. I'm telling you, I gotta meet her husband, Ralph. Every time she mentions her husband, Ralph, you're gonna laugh. Of course, Elizabeth Olsen and Paul Bettany, they're amazing. They embody Vision and the Scarlet. When I attended, you know, the press junket last weekend where Elizabeth Olsen talked about filming this, and she filmed this in front of an audience You know, you hear the laugh tracks and everything, but it's really filmed in front of an audience, and you know, that's a lot different than what she's used to. And she talked about how it was different and how it kind of made her brain, I think she said her brain crazy. So, I mean, her performance was spot on, considering even the fact that she filmed this so differently. Now, with each episode, you get that silliness and campiness and, you know, that Disney feel with these episodes. But underneath it all, you get these strange moments. You do. You get strange moments that things happen where you kind of get the feeling something more dark and sinister is going on. As each episode plays out, you know, things start to unfold and you begin to get a thicker plot of, well, we don't know yet. Because it definitely leaves you after the third episode on a cliffhanger, an amazing cliffhanger. But as someone who only got to watch the first three, I can't wait to the fourth episode, because I feel like that's when things are really going to pick up. I enjoyed all three. The first two episodes were a little bit of a slow burn, kind of introducing you to just the sitcom feel and a little clues here and there. But it really begins to pick up on the third, and especially by the end of the third, you're like, and they have fun little things within each episode. Like there's a commercial, you know, in each, which kind of stays with that time. You get a 1950s feel commercial vibe with, you know, the first episode, a 1960s commercial vibe with that. But also, as we were told during the interview, Kevin Feige let us know that each commercial within each episode kind of gives you clues for things to come in the MCU. Instead of, which we don't get end credit scenes in these episodes, we are going to get those same clues within the commercials, which I love. All right, y'all. WandaVision drops on Disney Plus. You get the first two episodes tomorrow, and then each new episode will be released every week after that. Let me know what you think. Let me know how excited you are. Comments, thumbs, all that. Until next time. Mwah.